Microsoft unveiled its new Windows operating system in San Francisco on Tuesday, trying to address some of the challenges faced by Windows 8. Instead of Windows 9, it called it Windows 10 to emphasize how big the changes are. The company did a lot to make Windows 10 feel familiar to people who are used to running older Win32-style apps.
If you look on the left side here, all of our system pins are present, as well as my most frequently used. It's important to note that you can see Windows desktop software there next to Windows Store apps. There's no more segregation of the two worlds.
Snapping in Windows 8 allowed you to open multiple apps and have them fit together on the screen. In Windows 10, snapping has become a lot more powerful. We took Snap and put it on steroids, as one engineer put it.
But I can take that further and snap the corners, and easily snap up to four apps if I want to.
The modern style of apps in Windows 8 used to occupy the full screen unless they were snapped together. But now the windows can be resized, as with older Win32 apps.
Our apps can scale, so notice how there's one, two, three stages of UI changes depending on how I choose to scale this app.
Users can create multiple desktops and switch between them so that you don't have to keep resizing windows when you use different combinations of apps.
I have two apps and I've predetermined a window value for them. Okay, now, completely separately, I have another desktop where I'm running CAD snapped with this window.
And there's a new search feature.
If I did a search for something like Wi-Fi, for example, you'll see settings, you'll see apps related to Wi-Fi, apps that I have installed and the store, and you'll also see web results here.
Older Win32 apps automatically fill the screen like the more modern style apps.
So when you go snap in Windows now, it will intuitively fill up to the edge of the next screen that's there.
From phones to tablets to desktops, the new operating system will run on all hardware devices when it ships next year. With reporting by James Nicolai in San Francisco, I'm Melissa Aparicio with the IDG News Service.